resistor divider operation. Let's learn the basic operation principle for a resistor divider. A resistor divider is a basic circuit technique that transforms voltage from a higher voltage to a lower voltage using just two resistors. The resistor values determine the ratio between the input voltage and the output voltage as shown in this equation. Let's say that you have a 5 volt input and you want to step down the voltage to only 1 volt. If you choose R1 to be 4 ohms and R2 to be 1 ohm, you can achieve this voltage step down correctly. This basic resistor concept can be used in DC-DC power conversion. Here we will learn about a very basic type of DC-DC converter. Say we have a DC source, like a battery, but our output is a device that needs a very specific DC voltage to operate properly. If we directly connect our battery to the load, the voltage will be too high and damage our device. So, we need some kind of DC-DC converter to step down the high voltage to a lower voltage. One of the simplest converters that we can use is a linear regulator. Its operation principle is based on a resistor divider. Let's take a closer look. Now we'll look at voltage conversion using a basic resistor divider. So in this case, we're going from DC input to DC output. Here we see our input is our VIN. Here, this is a DC voltage. Let's assume it's a battery or some sort of DC source. And our output is actually going to be this R2. This is our load resistor. And our output voltage is from this point to ground, as shown here. What we want to do, we're going to say our goal is to maintain a 5 volts at our output voltage. So 5 volts over this resistor. And we're going to say that our resistor is 5 ohms. And our input voltage, we're going to say, is about 10 volts. So we have a 10 volt input and we have a 5 ohm load and we want to maintain 5 volts over the load. We can use a resistor divider as shown here. We put a resistor in series, this R1 in series, and we can use the resistor divider equation that we learned earlier to figure out what value we should put in R1 to make sure that our output is 5 volts. If we do the math, we'll see that we need to put 5 ohms here in order to get 5 volts over our output. So if we do the math for that, we have Vout equals 5 over 5 plus 5. This is our resistor divider equation. Multiply that by our input voltage, which is 10 volts, and we'll get exactly 5 volts as our output over here, which is exactly what we want. So we just put our R1 here with a specific value and we're able to achieve our 5 volts output. However, in real life, our input voltage may not be exact. For example, if we're using a battery, as we use the battery, the voltage will start to decrease. So let's say that our VIN now becomes a little bit lower. Maybe it's 9 volts. Our load is still 5 ohms. And let's say we're using the same circuit setup. So we have 5 ohms as R1 as well. And here we're looking at V out. If we do the math here, use our same resistor divider equation, we see that V out is going to be 5 plus 5 as the denominator, and then 5 in the numerator, just as before. But this time our input voltage has changed. So now it's 9 volts. So we do the math, we see V out is actually 4.5 volts. And this is too low. We want to maintain our V out at exactly 5 volts. What can we do here? Well, our R2, our load, is fixed at 5 ohms. So the only thing that we can change is we can change our R1 value. So if we want to maintain 5 volts at the output, we're going to have to change R1 in order to achieve that. If we do the math again, we'll see that we need to make this 4 ohms. And if we do the math on that, we'll see that our new Vout value will be 5 over 5 plus 4 times 9 volts this time, which will give us exactly 5 volts, which is our goal here. So as our input voltage decreased, we also had to change R1 in order to maintain 5 volts at our output. These were two specific cases, but what if our input voltage is going to vary over an even wider range? Say it initially is 10 volts, but it can go up to 11 volts or all the way down to 9 volts, maybe even a wider range. Here again, our output resistor is still 5 ohms. So what can we do to make sure that our output is always 5 volts? Well, we're going to have to change R1 a little bit. So let's do some quick math based on these input voltages. What would R1 need to be for these values? If we do Vin, if it's 11 volts, we see that R1 needs to be 6 ohms. We just calculated if it's 10 volts, it needs to be 5 ohms. If it's 9 volts on the input, we need 4 ohms. And you can see here there's some trends in how the resistor is going to increase or decrease with the Vin. To achieve this more dynamically, instead of picking discrete values and putting them into R1, we can use a variable resistor. I draw an arrow through this. This is called a variable resistor, and we can change the resistance of this R1 resistor in order to maintain exactly 5 volts at the output. So using a variable resistor and a resistor divider, we can control and the output voltage and make sure that it maintains the correct voltage that we want to achieve. So far, we have shown the basic operation of a resistor divider and how we can use this circuit technique to create a voltage step-down DC-DC converter. As the input voltage changes, we need to adjust the resistor value in order to maintain the target output voltage. The difficulty with this simple circuit is that we have to manually change this resistor value based on the input voltage. However, this is not a realistic solution for a system that frequently changes input voltage. This very basic resistor divider converter can work in situations where the input voltage is very constant, but has room for improvement.